Welcome back to the channel. Hope everybody's doing well. And in today's video, we are taking a look at the Metrahit IM from Gossen Metrawatt. This is a more specialised instrument, primarily aimed at testing motor windings, and it comes in three different versions. The version I have here, this is the IM Xtra BT. This will set you back a cool £2,326.80, including UK VAT. For that, you also get the meter itself. You get a charger, although that's not compatible with the UK plug system. You get charger lead. You get a set of standard probes, red and black. You get a set of Kelvin clips for the four-wire resistance measurement. And you get this remote probe here for controlling the insulation test function. Literature-wise, you do get a license for the Gossen Metrawatt software that you can use to create certificates with this instrument. You do get a test certificate for this. This is their DAC system, which I believe is comparable to the UCAS system in the UK. And then you get a little bit of literature for the remote probe here and the rechargeable battery, the milliohm leads, and then a basic manual for working the instrument. The full manual for it is downloadable in PDF format from the Gossen Metrawatt site. All of that comes in this plastic case you see at the back here. There is a cheaper version available for this, which is the IM Tech BT. That goes for £2,086.80. However, it does not have this core test function and the insulation test function. It does have four wire resistance and it does have these multimeter functions. Accessory wise, I believe it comes with all the accessories that you see here, the same as the IM Xtra. The third version of this is the IM eDrive BT, which I believe is aimed at electric vehicles. Now, I believe that has exactly the same functionality as this IM Xtra. However, it comes in an orange boot and the case for it is orange as well. And instead of dual KC4 Kelvin clips, you get one Kelvin clip plus a Kelvin probe, the duplex probes that you use for four wire measurement. However, that's the most expensive version, setting you back £2,422.80. So quite an investment for these meters here. So the instrument and all of its accessories, they fit inside this foam padding inside the case. You do have here an extra slot for another battery should you want it. And the instructions, software license, etc. fit behind this little flap inside the lid. You can tuck them in behind there. However, this is quite a flimsy little case, as you probably saw just then. The hinges on this are all plastic. The hinge pin there is all plastic. The catches are all plastic. So it may not be overly robust as it gets put to use. Only time will tell with that one, really. So there are a number of accessories that are available for this instrument. Some I have here, others I haven't purchased. You can get a replacement battery or an extra battery. As you can see, this is quite a unique unit for the Metrahit IM there. So you can only get a replacement from Gossen Metrawatt. And that will set you back £163. Available on all three versions of the instrument. You can also get temperature probes. There are actually five different versions for the temperature probes. This particular one I have here is for surface measurement. And this will set you back £73. There are a couple of other versions similar to this handheld variety that are for measuring air temperature or liquid temperature, and they are each available for £59. And the other two versions that I don't have here that are a little bit different to this, that's a stainless version available for £198 and a PTFE watertight version that's available for £78. So for the resistance measurement function, you see I have the KC4 lead set included in this version. That is available separately. You can purchase that for £239 if you have a version without them. This set didn't come with any duplex probes at all. So I purchased this set, but this set currently retails for £467 in the UK. And these are the duplex ones, the all Kelvin ones that you get for measuring the four wire resistance. As you saw in the original kit, it doesn't come with crocodile clips for the leads, so you can get Gossens themselves. This set here, the red and black, will actually set you back £54. And it's those ones. Now for the IM Xtra and the IM E-Drive that have the coil test function, you don't get the coil test box with this. You can use the old coil adapter. That will work with the instrument, but you do get this more enhanced version that's available as a three-phase unit, and you've got a couple of different ranges, a low range and a high range built into this unit. That unit there, that will set you back £335, and that doesn't include the test lead set. So three-phase there, you need a three-phase test lead set. If you choose to go down that route, that's these ones here. These do come with the crocodile clips, a red, blue and black crocodile clip included, and that will set you back £119. Now you could save yourself a bit of money because this does come with a red and black crocodile clip for use with the standard leads as well, instead of buying the extra ones from Gossen. That's all the accessories that I have. There are a couple of extras out there. There is a 100 amp current clamp that goes for £185 and a 150 amp current clamp that goes for £199, and that will work with all the instruments. You also have a couple of specialist test lead for the E-Drive version of this that plug into the AC type 2 socket. There is £99.60, and there is also a CCS test lead set as well that retails for £141.60 should you want them. Now all these extras are all well and good, however for the case that you have here you do start to struggle. There are two slots here for the battery, so you can plug in extra battery in there should you want to. Obviously croc clips will go in easy enough, and your temperature probe will probably also fit somewhere in there, not too bad. And then you end up with the duplex leads. You can just kind of shuffle them around, and these do fit in here. I'm not making a very good job of this one, am I? But they will crunch up in there, and you'll be able to close your lid reasonably easy. See, it closes down there, not too bad at all. Unfortunately, that leaves you with this great big box here in the form of the coil adapter and the three-phase test lead set, which kind of doesn't fit too well inside the box, does it? So accessories are all well and good. However, if you go to the length that I've gone to here, you're going to need to buy yourself a new case or an extra case as well. Okay, so we'll get that out of the way and we'll take a look at the actual meter itself. So just have a quick look at the actual instrument construction itself. You've got the ports down here at the bottom for plugging in the test leads. You can see you have the blanking facility that's designed by Gossen Metrawatt. You see on a lot of their instruments that will release the port when you go around to the amps and the four wire resistance. At all of the points, the amps is blocked off, so you can't create an error with plugging the leads into the wrong port. Function switch in the center here, that's got the off position and then all the various functions. Some of the functions are two position. So with the insulation function there, you get the coil and voltage, hertz and duty cycle and so on. We'll go through them in a bit. Then you've got some menu buttons here that are used for selecting the sub functions off of each of these main functions. And then you also have some function buttons along here that change operation of what they do based upon what appears on the screen itself. The actual instrument is housed in this big rubber housing here, pretty robust housing, although the instrument does come out of it very easily. At the back here you have the stand. This is on this like pressed rubber seam for the stand itself, so I'm not sure how long that will last, but only time will tell. You also have this little metal clip here that you can bring up and then hang it on a screw or a nail or something like that. That stores away in there. And then inside underneath here, you do have the fuse compartment that you can just get to and do that screw down there, and that flips the lead out to get to the fuses. So you can just get to it whilst the instrument is within its boot. That's pretty much the instrument itself in there. To get the battery out, this is the battery you can see here. You've got these two kind of buttons on the side here. You press those in and you'll see the battery will pop up very slightly, and then it will just lift out. And then to charge this, it's charged away from the meter itself. So if you have only one battery, then once you've used it, that's it. You plug this into the little port here, and then you're off to a standard USB 5 volt there, either from a wall adapter or a computer. And then once that's done, it will unplug and you can plug it back in and away you go again. Battery, I've had this last pretty much a day for me, so it's not been too bad. But obviously if you do an awful lot of testing during a day, then you might find you need two batteries, or you've got to wait until you've recharged this one. So the meters itself, let's put you in there and switch him on. First function is the insulation test and the coil test on the other side there. The function is selected from this menu screen here. So the first position, so the first function you come to is the insulation test. The voltage can be changed with the up and down arrows here. You can see it changing at the top there, and then 150 volts. And then these other functions here, manual and auto, or the data button. And then you can start the test with this button here. To change the functions over, you hit the function on the right hand side. First one you come to is the coil test, which is over there. And then you press it again, and then you get a DAR test. And then you press it again, and then you get a polarization index test. And then you're back to the insulation test. Insulation test function. On the 250 volt, 500 volt and 1000 volts, you can go up to 3 gigaohms. You can only go up to 300 mega ohms on the 50 volt and 100 volt test voltages. Accuracy on that is 5% plus 10 digits. And then when you go through onto the coil test, you can see it goes to microseconds value. That will do 10 to 250 microseconds, which is on 10% plus 5 digits. That's your insulation test function. Voltage wise, you switch over, it defaults to AC volts there, and then when you go through the function again, you can go to Hertz then, and then duty cycle, and then you get speed on there, and then you get a VFD mode with a filter on it, and then we're back to AC voltage. Do you have a zero function here, or a relative function for the AC? And then you've got manual and auto, data again, similar to the insulation test setup. For volts AC, we are looking at 10 microvolts to 1000 volts overall, and it's 0.5% plus 30 digits. So for our frequency, you can measure 0.01 hertz up to 300 kilohertz for an accuracy of 0.05% plus 5 digits. The duty cycle, you can measure from 10 to 90% with an accuracy of 0.2% plus 8. And our RPM, it measures from 30 RPM up to 30,000 RPM. Don't have an accuracy for that particular measurement. Switching over to DC function. Again, similar setup for the buttons along the bottom here as per the AC. You start off with DC volts. You then go to AC DC volt mode. And then you go to AC-DC volt modes with filter applied. And that brings it into a manual range. It doesn't have an auto range in this mode. And then you're back to DC again. We are again 10 microvolts to 1000 volts. This time we are 0.2% plus 30 digits with regard to the accuracy. Switch over to the ohms. And we've got capacitance and temp down there. So again, function over here. Our ohms, and we've got our capacitance mode there, and we've got our temperature mode. The temperature, we've got PT100. If you press it again, we get the K type up, and then we go back to the ohms. Ohms wise, we are 10 milliohms to 30 mega ohms with a 0.15% plus 10 digits. capacitance, we go to 10 picofarads up to 300 microfarads, which is 1% plus 6 digits. And temperature wise, we are minus 250 degrees C to 1372 degrees C. That is 1% plus 5. What I didn't just do actually. So you can change between degrees C and Fahrenheit. You go to the menu button, you've then got specific settings for this measurement, and you go to that one, and then you can change PT100 sensor, you can change it there, and hit the OK, and then you can change it to 1000 or 100. And we skip that one, we go down, and there's your digits there, your units there. You can change between Fahrenheit and degrees C there. And then the bottom one here, that gives you the nominal lead resistance, so you can effectively null out your leads for measuring temperature with a RTD rather than a thermocouple. So that's those ones there, just escape them out and take them back to your main menu. The next one is your continuity function. You know, the only one you can do with this one really is change your cutoff point for your continuity. Which you do with the arrow keys, you can change it all the way from 1 ohm all the way up to 90 ohms, depending on what setting you would like there for yourselves. And the next setting is for the bond. You can change the bond test, which is like an earth wire resistance test, between 20 milliamp and 200 milliamps with these buttons here. And then this button here now gives you a polarity change, so you can change between the polarity on the red probe or on the black probe, so you can do your bidirectional test should you want to. So for our bond test, we are 1 milliohm to 30 ohms. Your accuracy is 2.5% plus 10 digits. Final one on this resistance measurements is our 4-wire resistance. You can now see the port down here has been released for 4-wire measurement. Again, our test current can be changed up here between 200 milliamp, 20 milliamp, or all the way up to 1 amp. And for our 4-wire resistance, so for our 20 milliamps, we can go 10 milliohms to 30 ohms. For 200 milliamps, we can do 10 micro ohms to 3 ohms. And for the 1 amp, you can do 1 micro ohm up to 300 milliohms. They all have a 0.5% plus 7 digits tolerance. And then finally, you move over to your amps. Function button on this just swaps between amps DC, which it defaults to. Then you get your amps AC and DC. And then you get your amps AC. And then you get frequency. And then you're back to amps DC. So for our amps measurement, you can measure from 10 nanoamps up to 1 amps. And then you have a 0.15% plus 10 digits accuracy for DC, and a 0.5% plus 30 digit accuracy for AC. You can also measure current with the clamp adapter, and to do that we need to go back to our voltage there, and then we can go into our menu for our current settings for this measurement, and here you see the clip here, go over to your clip, OK, and then you've got the ratios here that you can put in for the different clamp there. And the same exists also for your DC amps. Just go there, go onto your menu, go up to the menu settings for this measurement, over to clip, there it is, and then again you can go through the different ratios that are available or leave it off. So that's there. For the current adapter, you can measure 0.3 amps up to 3 kiloamps. Obviously the accuracy for that will also be dependent upon what type of clamp you use with the instrument. So that's a quick run through of all the functions on the instrument there. There is an awful lot to go through on this instrument, so that'll be it for this video. I'll do some other videos with regard to the actual uses of this instrument, especially with regard to 4-wire resistance measurement and your coil testing facility you've got there as well. Thanks for watching. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you again in the next video.